So you see how she's working. Initially, he doesn't have choice, and she's just inching back a little bit by a little bit. And each time, he has to make more and more of a decision. So already, the dog has a pattern to come into you because they've done it numerous times and been rewarded when they didn't have a choice. They couldn't make a mistake, right? Or not that mistake. They couldn't take the front side. Has a choice, but it's not quite as tempting as like if you were sitting right in front of the tunnel. Naughty pants. He hadn't even been released. And this, of course, is like if maybe time is getting rewarded for taking the tunnel on her own and offering, this is when you're going to have a problem, right? Because what if you don't want the front side? You just spend as much time at whatever stage that you need to that the dog is mostly successful, right? If you put them further back and they have like three or four failures in a row, then they needed more help, right? And again, when I say more help, I mean go back to an earlier stage of the training, the previous stage of the training. I don't mean help more by, for instance, standing further out or changing your cues or anything. And again, this is a train. This is trained. So if you haven't been practicing, there's no reason to expect that the dog will be able to do it this week versus last week, right? You have to actually train this. So if you haven't done the training at home, then start